A lot of scam artists will say and will encourage you to invest in what they call a prime bank note. Do any of you know what a prime bank note is? Because I need to talk to you, you can do, because prime bank notes don't exist. But I'll tell you what, they can show you a beautiful certificate. A beautiful, like it looks like a stock certificate. And they'll come to you and they'll say, you know, prime bank notes are sold in large denominations, and it's how the Warren Buffets and the super rich invest their money. That's a lie. There's no such investment instrument as a prime bank note. But it sounds good. They can print it out on paper and it looks good, but it does not exist. But those are the types of things that are out there, and you know, particularly when we're talking about a time and the time we're living in, and many people, and probably the folks in this room can identify with this more than anything. But we're living in a very unsettling time in this country. Our financial markets are somewhat in peril. Some of you in this room probably remember the last time this nation went through that. But any time that we're in this situation, people are going to be looking for places to save their money. You know, I've talked to a lot of bankers. And I told one of the TV stations, I talked to them, you should feel very secure in investing your money in the banks here in West Virginia. West Virginia has a very strong bank association. The West Virginia community bankers and the banks doing business in West Virginia are very sound, solid banks. And I have no concern about my money that is invested and my money that is sitting in deposit in the bank that I do business with here in West Virginia. Our banks are very strong. There is somewhat of a banking crisis nationally, but our banks here in West Virginia are very sound and very strong. So don't have fear. And I've talked to some bankers, and people are going in and pulling their money out. Let me encourage you, do not panic. Our banks are strong in West Virginia. They're sound places to hold your money. But people get concerned. They go and they pull out, and I actually talked to a man the other day that had withdrawn $100,000 out of his bank. And he was going to take it home and basically put it in his mattress because he was concerned. But he's the kind of guy that can be swayed by investing in a scam like a prime bank note, because they're going to tell him he's going to get 10% return on that money. So all I can say is be cautious, be concerned. Don't invest that you don't check it out. Let me just tell you, we were talking about church today and how important that is. And that's something that's very important in my life. Let me talk to you a little bit about my church in Parkersburg, which is where I live, and how a fraud occurred within my church. Many times, people that are out here perpetrating these economic frauds on seniors and on the population or the public in general, a lot of times they will do what we call affinity fraud. They will infiltrate a social organization, a club, or a church. They will identify somebody that is well respected. They will identify a deacon or an elder in the church, or a club president, or somebody that they can identify as being well respected within a peer group of individuals. I saw this happen firsthand. We had a gentleman in my church that had done very well for himself in life. He was no Warren Buffett, but it seems like everything that man touched or every business opportunity he got into in life, God blessed him and he had a great return on those investments. Well, they targeted this man and convinced him into investing money into a fraudulent scheme. And he did that. And they paid him a great return on his money for 3 months. And then they come and approach him and say, you know, we're going to open up and allow a few more investors in. Do you know anybody that you know that you go to church with that may be interested in this? And this man, thinking he was doing something good, invited many members of the church and people that he knew into this investment. Unfortunately, him, as well as those other people, lost virtually every dime they put into that investment. This type of stuff happens all the time. This type of stuff happens right here in West Virginia. Many times we think we're insulated from that type of problem, but we're not. And the message, if I get one message across to you today, I want you to know that regardless of who comes to you and talks to you about investing money, can be your best friend. Don't blindly invest or trust your money with anybody that you don't do your homework with, that you don't check them out yourself and make sure that they are telling you the truth. And one other thing, anybody that is licensed to invest money on your behalf in the state of West Virginia has got a strong set of rules and laws that they must adhere to. And one of the most fundamental laws that we have in place is that any investment advisor or any stockbroker is bound by law to make sure that if he steers you to an investment, that it is a suitable, the law calls it a suitable investment for you. And a suitable investment is a very broad definition. But I will just use the example that if you're like my father, who is 81 years old, that it would be inappropriate for anybody to encourage him to invest money that did not have a quick, immediate return and a safe return. It would be inappropriate for them to get him to invest money in something that may be a 10-year return when he's 81 years old. I pray that the good Lord allows my father to be on this earth for many, many years. But these are the types of things that a licensed, registered investment advisor or a broker is bound to do to make sure he invests your money within a risk tolerance that you can afford, as well as that those investments are suitable for you to invest.
First, about Auditor Gaynor. Auditor Gaynor has been West Virginia State Auditor since 1994. As a result of being the auditor in the West Virginia statute, Code 32 says that the state auditor of West Virginia shall be also the commissioner of securities. So that's where the jurisdiction and authority comes in from to be the securities commissioner. Auditor Gaynor, in addition to being auditor, he's also the chairman of the National White Collar Crime Unit that's housed here in Fairmont. Nextly, Auditor Gaynor has an office in Clarksburg. It's a regional office. To preclude folks from having to drive to Charleston when they have business to do with the auditor's office, it makes it very convenient. So a couple of things that he's done, and that's the office that I actually work out of. Tracy works out of the Capitol, but it makes it very convenient having an office in Clarksburg. We're here to talk about securities. And there's a couple messages that I want to leave you here with, a couple of buzzwords, a couple of ideas. But most importantly, if you leave here with not anything else, just remember two little things. Investigate before you invest. Investigate before you invest. Okay, now, I don't think that there's anybody in here that would buy a car without kicking the tires. I don't think so. Why would you take your hard-earned money? Why would you take your retirement and just put it in somewhere without checking it out first? We're going to simplify that. We're going to simplify that investigation that you do. We're going to simplify it with an 800 number that's paid for by guess who? You, the taxpayers. It's a paid for by the taxpayers' number. In other words, it's your number. You own it. You just allow us to manage it. And it's called 1-888-SAFE-WBA, SAFE, Seniors Against Investment Fraud, West Virginia. High-risk investments. Brokers are not allowed to put folks, senior citizens, in high-risk investments. They're not allowed to do that. Senior citizens have to have their money upon demand. They can't be in stuff that has a high risk to it that's going to take a long time for it to return. They're not allowed to do that. When you're dealing with a broker, find out how you get paid. That's important. But you know what else is more important than that? Find out how they get paid. Your broker dealer, your agent, ask them another question. Ask them if they sell your information to a third party. Okay? Find out if they sell your information to a third party, because that's where a lot of these scams come from. Because they have so much of your information that it's convincing. So find out where it comes from. So find out if your broker dealer or your agent, if that corporation, company, whoever it is you're dealing with, they sell your information to marketers. It's important to know. 80% of the victims, 80% of the victims never investigate before they invest. They never check that out. That's why they're victims.
If any of you that have not done it, sometimes go on your computer and put your name in and do a search. You will be shocked at things that come up. You will find things about you that probably you didn't even know.
Or you'd forgotten.
Or wish you'd forgotten. Which brings me to my next point, that those of us who are senior citizens, over the years, our Social Security numbers have sometimes got input improperly. So when I'm an investigator, I'm investigating these things, and you give me your Social Security number, and I start doing a check on it, they say, also check 232 da 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 da. There may be a list of 6 to 8 Social Security numbers that may pertain to you. Therefore, when you get your accounting from the Social Security office that says you have been credited with X numbers of dollars for that particular year, check it out. Because your contributions may be going to somebody else under a different number. That would be an honest mistake. However, it does occur. So, beware. There's what you mentioned earlier. Many seniors have a substantial amount of savings which is used to supplement their retirement. That's the number for SAIF, and there are the four components. If you're going to invest, you've got a question, or somebody's been saying, call SAIF first. Consult with somebody you trust, consider all your options, and compare the product to others. Now, I want you all to do three things for me. Look to your left. Look to your right. Look to in front of you. And behind you. Do you see anybody in this room that you would trust with your money? Why do you go to some stranger or go online and give them your money? Made you think, didn't it?
You think you can get addicted to the internet?
Yep.
Think kids can?
Yes.
You know, you ask kids, middle school and younger, and I say middle school meaning ninth grade too, okay? And here's what you get. Everybody in the room yells, yes, when you ask that question. Do you think you can get addicted to texting? Yes. They all yell. Everybody. Then you get up to senior and junior, and they're like, they won't say anything. And what's that mean? They're addicted already. The other kids don't know the danger. They know that they like getting on there, but the older kids don't want to admit it anymore. Now, that's a real sign of addiction. There's one thing we teach them to brag on, though. From practically the day that they can walk, but not quite, from about 5 to 6 years old on, Anybody have any idea what that is? And we should never be teaching them to brag on this online. I'm a Parkersburg Big Red. I'm a Jackson General. I don't know. I'm a Roane County what?
Raider.
But see, that tells a predator right where mom and dad aren't. And here's what they'll do. It's called grooming. They'll take a young child and they'll say, "You were late getting home from school today. What, do you have track?" "Well, no, you know I don't run track. I play basketball." "Oh, you're that 5'9" forward." "No, I play center." And in about three questions, this person can walk right in the gymnasium and say, "Right there she is." And I say she, but the National White Collar Crime Center says almost 30% of the predators are women. So the little dudes are in trouble too. They're in danger. Cell phones, we've talked about cell phones, but if you get cell phones for your children, I encourage you to get them that don't take pictures, okay, and limit the text to you, okay? Don't set them up so that they can text anyone and receive texts from anyone. PayPal, I want you to look at PayPal like it's your bank. Anybody in here have PayPal? Got one. PayPal's owned by eBay. But they'll ask you to reactivate your account, tell you your account's been suspended, and different things. And they're trying to get you to log into the Resolution Center. If you do, you'll get this screen. Now, this is called phishing, and you need to be aware of it, because younger kids get drawn into this, okay, in requests, and they'll give up usernames and passwords. So the only thing that works on that screen are these two boxes. If you send your email address and password, looks like it's needing focused a little, there we go, then you send that to a dirt bag and they'll turn right around and log into your bank account or your PayPal account, whatever account it looks like you've got. Now, what do you think they're looking for? Anybody have an idea? I'm going to show you. Now, this is another one, by the way. Coming up, we're going to be filing taxes. The IRS will not send you this stuff on email, telling you they're going to give you a refund stuff. Ignore it. Delete it. Better not to even open it. But right there is what they're looking for. Social Security number. Every state has three allotted to them as an opening number, and then the center numbers are the group numbers. Now, online you can find these Social Security number calculators that anyone in the world can use. Anyone in the United States, anyone in Iran, anyone. All the bad guys as well as all the good guys. So right there is every state's allotment. That came offline. Okay, and then there it says 233. There are actually some 232 West Virginias. And then if you have an email or a Social Security number that has the 86 in it, you got it in 1968. Any questions? This is our number, State Auditor's Office. If you desire one of these presentations, please give us a call. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. My name is James Rutledge, and this is Tracy Phillips. We work for the State Auditor of West Virginia. His name is Glen B. Gaynor III. Now, what we're here today to do is a presentation called Money Matters. We talk about credit cards, debt from credit cards, savings and investing, frauds and scams, and we want to play two games. Who's heard of the stock market?
Woo!
These products you see on the board are owned by these four companies we have in our hand. What is the main purpose of the stock market, first of all?
Make money.
To invest.
Good. Now, we ask that question, we hear a lot of crazy answers. There's only one answer. The reason you invest in the stock market is to make money. Is it risky?
Yes.
Absolutely. This first company is Kellogg's. Everybody knows who Kellogg's is, right?
Yes,
I hope so, unless you've been under a rock. Okay, Kellogg's. Their stock symbol is K. So at the bottom of the screen on TV, when you see all these little tickers and these numbers going by, arrows going up and arrows going down, and 20 cents and 30 cents, $1.15. It's the price of the stock throughout the day. Okay, I think ESPN got that from the money ticker from ESPNBC and all these money channels. Okay, it's called the ticker. And when you see a K, you'll know that's Kellogg's. Okay? General Mills. It's GIS. Kraft. KFT. And Conagra Foods. CHE. Now I know most of you have heard three, maybe who's heard of Conagra Foods? It's not real popular, but they own a lot of stuff. Of course, their group owns a lot of those up there. So each company that I showed you owns 10 food products. What your group is going to do is talk about it for about a minute, okay? We don't have to do this all day. Talk about it for a minute, and then a person of your group will come up and put the appropriate companies over top the appropriate products that that company owns. And what it goes back to show you is, when you're investing in the stock market, these are decisions you need to make, and these are things you need to learn before you invest. You need to learn, if you're going to invest in Conagra Foods, you should know who they own, because it's your money. Like I said,
we've got it.
Sometimes those tricky come off, so you might want to hold the display when you take them off. Okay. Can everybody see that? I know it's hard for you to see all of them. It's not Taco Bell, the restaurant, it's Taco Bell, the furnishings you get at the store. Like the shells and the sauces. It's not Taco Bell, the store. Has anybody talked about interest rates in class? Okay. They're good interest rates and there's bad interest rates. To the good, when interest works for you, it's stocks and savings accounts, CDs. Okay? When it works against you, it's credit cards, it's loans, car payments, house payments. Okay? And unfortunately, when it works for you, it's not that good. Okay? This is 18.99% on this credit card. If you charge $750 worth of merchandise and you pay back $15 a month, it will take you 8 years and 4 months to pay it off. That's a long time. So let's say everybody's a junior in this class today. You're 3 years out of college plus 4 months. You just now paid off a credit card what you charged when you were a junior at Bridgeport High School. Okay? That's a long time. I tell you what, the first person that gives me a dollar gets it. A real dollar bill. $1 bill, first one. Let's go. I'm not coming. Come on.
I got nine.
Okay, man.
Congratulations.
There you go. Here's over here. Hey, hey. Is it empty?
Open it up.
It's empty.
What?
It's right. That's right. We'll see.
Very good. Very good.
And I hate to do that to anybody, but you know what? All seriousness, it's better have it. Hold up. Okay? Everybody just be quiet for a second. Okay? Listen, it's better have it in here for a joke than in real life. Because in real life, you won't get your dollar back, and it won't be a dollar. It'll be 500, 1,000, or more. Okay? We see this stuff all the time. We like to do this so everybody sees. The reason we're doing it is because in real life this happens, and you do not get your money back. It's fun in here, and it's funny in here. Okay? But in real life, it's not funny. And it's a lot more than a dollar.
Go ahead.
After you drop that, could you get it for like fraud or something like that? Or?
Well, that's you hear what he asked? Could you get them for like fraud or something? Oh yeah, you could. The only problem is you never see them. You think they're sticking around after they rip you off? They're done, they're gone. You're not gonna see them again. And if you do catch them, what do you think you're gonna get out of them? It's all gone.